Do you have reports or dashboards in Zoho Analytics that you'd like to be able to access from Zoho CRM? Hi, my name is Zach Spader, and I'm with Cornerstone Solutions. And today I'm going to show you how to embed your reports and dashboards that you created in Zoho Analytics into Zoho CRM. Let's take a look. Okay, so we're in my demo CRM account here. And if you've used CRM for any amount of time, you know that there are a lot of reporting features within the CRM itself. Reports, dashboards, dashboard components, things like that, that you can add into home screen dashboards and things like that. But as you've probably run into, they can be somewhat limiting. So a lot of people, after they run into some roadblocks with the built-in CRM reporting, they switch over to Zoho Analytics, which gives you a lot more functionality. But it's a separate application. It's a separate place you need to go to view data. And so let's say that you have a dashboard in Analytics and you need to be able to access this information all the time, but you mostly live in the CRM. And so, of course, you want to be able to view this dashboard from the CRM, even though it was created in Zoho Analytics. So today I'm going to show you how to do that. So I have a dashboard. This is one of the pre-created dashboards for CRM in Zoho Analytics. It's called the Leads Overview. It has a little bit of data in it, just to kind of show you some numbers. So what I need to be able to do first is I'm going to share this dashboard and get a URL for this particular dashboard. Now, when I'm on the view screen here, I have a share option up at the top. I'm going to click on that. And then what I want is a URL for this. And so I'm going to choose the URL option. Okay, now there's lots of different permission settings in Analytics. It's very heavily regulated as far as like permissions, who can access what, who has access to what data and things like that. And so for our demonstration today, I'm gonna strip all of the permissions off of this so that we don't run into any permission issues. Now, if you're dealing with more sensitive data and you want to make sure that this data isn't accessed by anybody else in your system, then you'll want to take a look deeper into the access permissions that you grant these URLs when you create them or create certain permissions within the CRM so that only the people that you want to access the data can actually access it. But for today's purposes, I'm just gonna strip all that off. We are just going to choose the access within organization or external users, and I'm going to choose public on the web. It means it has no restrictions whatsoever. I can just add this URL anywhere, and anybody with the URL can view it. Okay, click OK, and I have my URL here. So I'm just going to copy this URL. I'm going to go back over to CRM. Okay, so I have a couple of different options of what I can do with this URL now that I'm back in the CRM here. So I have a home screen. And so every user has their own home screen. And I could add this to my home screen. So if I wanted to do that, I would need to go into setup here. So I'm going to click on setup. The first thing that I need to do is I need to create a widget. And so under Developer Hub here, I'm going to click widgets. I'm going to create a new widget. We'll just call it Analytics Dashboard. For type, I'm going to use it as a home screen dashboard. So I'm going to click Home Page Dashboard. Hosting, this is crazy. Choose external instead of Zoho. I know it's crazy, but choose external. It'll work better. Then you're copying and pasting your URL in here and click Save. Okay, so now I have this Analytics Dashboard widget. Now, if I go back to my home screen now and I click on Add Component, one of the options is Widgets. I'm going to select Widgets. Here's my Analytics Dashboard. Just click Install. I have to give it a name again. Let's call it Analytics Dashboard again. Save. Okay, and now it's going to be all the way down at the bottom here. So here's my Analytics Dashboard component that we added in, and it's added to my dashboard. Now I can reorder the component if I want to. If I want to make it bigger, I can drag it up to the top. Let's see, drag it up here. So it's above my other components. Oops. Didn't work out very well. I want to make it bigger. Space on the screen. Can do that. And I can save it. Okay, so that's one option here. So now when I log into the CRM, right on my home screen dashboard here, I have my analytics dashboard. I can view that right from the CRM. Okay, second way I can do this is the CRM has the ability to create custom dashboards. And so I can go into setup here and I can click customize homepage. There's a default homepage that they give you. If I want to create a new one, I can create a new homepage. I can use a widget here because we've already created the widget for the analytics dashboard. I can select this. I can make it bigger. So we'll call this the analytics dashboard. Okay. The great thing about this option is doing it as a custom homepage is that with the first option, that's only visible to you, the user that does that. And so each user would have to do that themselves to add that dashboard to their home screen. With the customized home screen, I can create that and then I can add other people to that. So I can choose by roles. So I can choose a particular role in the organization. I can also choose profiles that need access to that. So I can specify, maybe I just want the administrators to see this particular dashboard. And so then if I save this, if we go back to the homepage then, of course it defaults to my user home, but now I have the analytics dashboard. And so other users who are admins in the system, when they log in, they'll have the option to choose the analytics dashboard here as their primary dashboard, and they'll be able to see this. So that's the second way that you can do this. The third way to do this is by creating a web tab. And so like, let's say that I like the home screen the way that it is. I want to keep the home screen as my basic CRM home screen, and I want to have a completely different tab in the system that I can view the analytics report on. So what I can do is I can come up here to setup, and I can go to modules and fields. And up here at the top, I have this web tab option. I'm going to click new tab. And let's call this analytics dashboard. And again, I can choose widgets. Now, you're wondering, why doesn't the widget that I created before show up here? And it's because we created that widget as a home screen dashboard. And this type of widget is specific to web tabs. So we have to recreate the widget again. So I'll just click create new widget. I'll give it a name. Again, select external hosting, copy paste my URL. Okay, now in the widgets here, we have the option to install the analytics dashboard too. I'm gonna click install again. With the web tab, you do have the ability to select who has access to that. So you can select, and this is by profiles that you're selecting this. So you don't have the roles option, you have the profile option of who has access to this web tab. So let's say I want administrators to be able to see this. I can click save here. And now if I refresh my page, if I go up here to my modules, you can see that down here at the bottom, I have the analytics dashboard. And you can see that the analytics dashboard displays right within this module here. So those are three different ways that you can pull analytics dashboards into the CRM. The same thing works with reports. If you have a report in Zoho Analytics, so let's say that you're not working with a dashboard, you just have an individual report that you want to see. You can have the share option in the report as well. You can create the URL permalink. So you can do the same exact thing with just a single report. But those are a couple different ways that you can add either reports or dashboards from analytics directly into your CRM so that you don't have to access multiple applications to be able to see the data that you want from one place. I hope this video has been helpful. Have a great day.
If you found this video helpful, be sure to like it and leave us a comment. You can also subscribe to our channel and click the bell next to the subscribe button to be notified of new videos. If you want to learn more about Zoho or would like help with anything Zoho related, head on over to our website at zcrmhelp.com to connect with us. Thanks for watching.